ladies and gentlemen, it's the little things that make a big difference. When we win because of the things that we know. When we lose because of the things that we don't know. So we've got to begin to take action right now. Action TNT, today, not tomorrow.
Mike Howard is a motivational speaker and peak performance trainer that will entertain, educate, and articulate proven ideas that'll help you maximize your potential. He worked almost 9 years as a computer programmer for IBM, and today he's programming people and organizations for success through his speaking and training workshops. Energy, style, enthusiasm, and professionalism best describe this dynamic speaker who is in demand throughout the country. This man delivers results. Now let's join Mike Howard as he helps you to optimize and maximize your potential.
Is that life pays an exact wage. What you give to life, life is going to give back to you. But what you withhold from life, life is going to withhold from you. The companies who succeed consistently are the companies who invest in their greatest resources, their people. So if you want your organization to go to the next level, you've got to invest in your people, your greatest resources. So we begin right now. Repeat after me. You don't have to be great to get started. But you've got to get started. If you want to be great. Greatness begins with a vision in the mind. Harvard University conducted a study, found out that 85% of the things that we accomplish in life after graduation is directly related to our attitude. A positive attitude will invite positive results, but a negative attitude will invite negative results. But ladies and gentlemen, don't let me go overboard with this thing called attitude. I don't want to be like the little boy who came running home and said, Dad, I think I flunked the test. The boy's father said, that's negative, boy, be positive. He said, Dad, I'm positive I flunked that test. No, I don't want to be like that. But I truly believe in the power of a positive attitude. As Zig Ziglar would say, a positive attitude won't let you do anything. But a positive attitude will let you do everything better than a negative attitude will. You see, a positive attitude will allow you to use your ability to the best of your ability.
Let me show you some examples of change. And see, in order for us to continue to grow, we've got to adapt and we've got to embrace this thing called change. And let me use some visuals just to show you. I'm gonna take you to Mike Howard's museum. Now, a long time ago, and some of you already still know people like this who have the old telephone. Remember this song? Now, I remember this phone from a long time ago because a long time ago, I used to always try to call in the radio station to win. And they say, caller number 13. I'm like, and I can never get through. You know, this has changed. I remember when call waiting first came out. You know, people, hold on. But things have changed now. You see, we've gone from that to this. Now, let me give you another example of change. See, a long time ago, when the phone would ring, you were like, hello? Yeah, who is this? Okay, hold on. But now, in 2006, this is what happens. Phone rings. Bill collector. And when things change, guess what? We've got to change. So let me give you some things that you can do to embrace this thing called change, because with change comes an opportunity for us to grow. Let's look at what we have. Number one, everything that you now enjoy is a result of what? Change. No change equals no what? Progress. Let's try another one. Change helps and position you to value your competition and changing economic what? Conditions. The next one, change is an opportunity for you to learn, adapt, and what? Grow. And I like this last one. I love it. The fact that you are asked to make changes means that you are still employed. I like that one. Give yourselves a round of applause. I like that. When you first wake up in the morning, don't listen to the news, don't read the newspaper, because it's negative. And the reason I say that is because the most powerful computer is this, the mind. It has over 100 billion neurons. So you've got to program that mind for success. So when you first wake up in the morning, I want you to listen to something positive, something inspirational, something motivational. You might even listen to a little Mike Howard in the morning time. Get your day going. Working on you. Now, next point. Right before you go to bed, don't go to bed listening to that negative stuff. Research studies show that what you hear 30 minutes before you go to bed will be repeated on average 16 times in your subconscious mind, while everything else is repeated on average 4 times. People go to bed after listening to the news. So what I do is that when I get up in the morning, I read something positive, I talk to myself, I have a little mini revival, I'm working on me. I'm saying, Mike, this is my day, you have what it takes. You go out and make it happen. Nobody can stop you unless you give them permission to do so. Guess what? Permission denied. That's how I started my day. Now, I'm looking out in the crowd and people are saying, Mike, you talk to yourself? Yes, I do. How many of you in this room talk to yourself? Raise your hands. Fantastic. Now, those of you who didn't raise your hands, did a little voice cough in the back of your mind and say, well, I don't talk to myself. And another one just went out and said, well, maybe I do. Of course we talk to ourselves. If you're not talking to yourself, you better be talking to a psychologist. So I work on me. Now let me share it with you. This attitude is contagious when you're in the workplace. The attitude that you show up with, it is contagious. It's just like when you go out and you yawn. Oh, man. If you do that, somebody's going to do it. But see, you can plant a seed of positivity in your team members when you go into the workplace. One day I was going to lunch, went to Piccadilly, my favorite place. And I went to Piccadilly and I walked in and I asked the lady, I said, how you doing? She said, what's wrong with you? I say, it's a great day. I say, I got up today, it's a great day. Well, everybody did that. So I just went on along the next day. So I was there 2 days later, I walked in. I say, I'm doing fantastic, how about you? What's wrong with you? So I just went on. She said, so what do you do? I said, I'm a motivational speaker. She said, motivate what? So I went on and I said, look, you just have a great day. So I came back the next day. I walked in like nothing had happened. I say, how you doing today? I say, I'm having a blessed day. It's a wonderful Wednesday. She said, you mighty cheery today. What you been drinking? But she said something. She said, what are you having today? I say, I'm going to have the spaghetti, I'm going to have the broccoli, and I'm going to have the green beans. She told him, give me his plate. She started piling it up. It was a $5.99 blue plate special. By the time she piled it up, I had enough to eat for 4 days. See, attitude changes people. Now when I go through, when I walk through that line, she said, give me his plate. I got him. $5.99, I eat for 5 days. It makes a difference. So attitude, I want you to work on your thing on that attitude, because when you go into the workplace, your attitude is so contagious. You see, I see so many people, they wish their lives away. They go through life, oh, I wish it were the weekend. Monday, oh, another Monday morning, don't know if I'm gonna make it. Oh, thank God it's Wednesday, 2 more days. And then they get to Friday, thank God it's the weekend. Now, they're happy Friday and Saturday, but by Sunday, 6 o'clock, they have a stress headache again. So we want to work on that. We want to work on that thing called attitude.